Hey guys, and welcome back to Mommy Cooks Homemade. My name's Hayley, for anyone who doesn't know. This is part one of the pantry clear out and reset. We also have a video sponsor for today too. This is the overview of the state of my pantry that goes way back into Narnia. There you go. This is what we're clearing out in part one. But first, I want to take a little segue off to today's video sponsor, who is Novet. So Novet has sent me a wireless doorbell with two receivers, and it has a remote connection of up to 400 meters, which is about 1300, and it does not interfere with any other equipment in your home. Yeah, that on its own is great. It's got 52 chimes, so you can pick which you want. That's your two receivers and your doorbell. It is super easy to put in, and it's as simple as you can either stick it onto your door, or you can do as Steve is doing here. This is it. This is the amount of installation required. That's it. And you can put the receivers absolutely anywhere. So it has the flashing light. So this is brilliant for anybody who's elderly. If you've got elderly parents and they're a little bit on the deaf side, there's two receivers. So they could have one in the bedroom and they could have one in the living room, say. If they're deaf and no amount, this is really, really loud, by the way, it will flash like that, and it'll do it at night as well. Two receivers, five adjustable volume levels ranging from 0 to 115 decibels. LED indicator alerts, so the flashing is excellent for people with impaired hearing, or you can turn the sound off altogether if it's not going to be of any use, or you've got kids in bed at night and just have it flashing. It's weatherproof and durable. The lithium battery is a lifespan of up to 3 years, so no need to worry about battery replacements, and it can withstand temperatures of -4 up to 140°F. You saw how easy it was to set up. You simply fit the thing outside. You can at the doorbell, press with the sticky pad or with the two screws. Then you've got your two receivers that you can plug in anywhere you want. And you can also add as well more transmitters should you wish them. It is currently on Amazon. The Amazon reviews for this are brilliant. It's absolutely brilliant. It's on offer at the minute. It's nearly 20% off. Plus there's a special discount code for all subscribers for another 10% off that as well. So it's not bad at all, really, but just go down to the description and click on the link below and go over to Amazon and have a look for yourself. Thank you to Novet for sponsoring this part of the video. Here I am. I'm going for the condiments first. I say condiments, I've got all sorts in here. I've got condiments and then I've got like gravy granules and yeah. That's just about empty, so I'm going to take that off, throw that out, wash the thing. And I find I've got more than one of something. I have dreaded doing this. So I'm still going. I'm still going on the condiments. It's like going back into Narnia. And three, yeah, there we go, look, Worcester sauce, and I thought we was running out. That gets chopped along with a few other things. Oh, embarrassing much. But you know what? You get these things and... Yeah. Me again. Look on my face. Didn't know that was in there. That was out of date. There we go. Didn't know that was in there. That's in date. I tried looking for a date on these and I couldn't find it. I'm still going, guys. I told you, it's like Narnia. Oh, look at that look. Gross. Condiments are the worst. And yeah, that's the stuff in the bin. In we go in. Good lord, my grey hairs are coming in now. So we've cleared it out. And I'm going to try and sort it out. That's anything to do with gravy or stock. Pickles. Here we go. See why this is part one? I don't even touch the spices at this point. So this is my condiments for my Chinese food. There goes the syrup. And things falling down. Right, sauces are going over there. At this point, I'm thinking, oh, Lord. And I've already got an headache. And this is just the first one. And it wasn't even the worst. I don't know how we accumulate so much stuff. I really don't. And the actual space on the shelves looks quite small. But it ain't. Like I say, it's like it goes back into Narnia, these cupboards. Right, that's the condiment shelf. Everything back in. There we are. Not too bad. Everything's sort of in a row, in a sort of section, coming forward. Oh, if only I knew that wasn't going to be the worst. So this is the worst part of my pantry. I've got taco seasoning in that bit, really. This is where I store, like... I don't even know. That's how bad it is. It used to be bread storage and crackers and that. But it's this big part is a dumping section. It really is. It's a dumping section. I mean, really, Steve, why put that back? There's two crackers in that. I chucked them. And he actually used a clip, which shocks the ever-loving out of me. Because he doesn't normally, he leaves them to go soft. He's a bloke. Now, I'm not saying old blokes do that, but Steve does. See, look, it's got cereals, it's got stuff I didn't even know we had. Believe it or not, this actually does get cleared out, but it ends up the same way again. These crackers, all these here, and what about at Christmas? Chuck them ones. I'm chucking all the bits onto the floor. I ain't done the hoovering. It's not been done, so it goes onto the floor. So I'm using white vinegar here to clean these. And they're not even that bad, to be honest. My pan cupboard was worse. So I haven't refilled that cupboard because I had a brainwave. Look at that one. That's meant to be my tins, but if you look underneath, we've got overflow going down into the rice and pasta section. So this is me having a brainwave. Why I didn't use this bigger cupboard for these before, I'll never know, but it is what it is. Can you tell I'm fed up with my cupboards? And I ain't even got to the spices and stuff in my spice cupboard. That's part two. Crazy, man, crazy. I have all sorts of tins, jars, as you can see. Yes, I do use them when I can't be bothered. It's still better than running down to a takeaway or buying a full, like, you know, the microwave meals and stuff. You still cook your own meat. You still put in what you want, but I use a jar. It just depends how I am that day. I think there's a lot of people on this channel with health related issues, and I think we're all the same. It all depends on that day, doesn't it? How we are. You just do your best. So I didn't realise I had like 6 cans of lump crab. What on earth? I was thinking to myself, there's 3. And there's another 3 there, look. And I was thinking to myself, oh, I'll have to get some more. I ain't used any in a while. I mustn't have any. That's what you get for not rooting your cupboard out. The beans and tomatoes I've kept. Oh, look at that cupboard, look. Ailey. Really? So, I'm moving up from the bottom. So these are all my jars or containers that store like risotto rice, orzo, pasta that goes in soups, blah, blah, blah. So I'm bringing them up a level. Didn't realise I had that pasta in either. Because I'm on the floor at this point. I don't ever get on the floor. And I paid for this. But it is what it is, isn't it? That's why I don't know what's on them 2 shelves. Because I can't get down there. So I figured I need to. I need to know what's down there properly. I mean, Steve's great. Steve's always great. But, you know, women, you know, if you need to be in the cupboards to find out what there is and sort them out, you just do it, don't you? Yeah, this was really, really painful. But I got it done as fast as I could. So I've got a container there that's got like straight to wok noodles, rice noodles, the kids' noodles. I'm moving everything that I use more regular up a level. No, I didn't realise I had all them dumpling mixes. Oh dear. I like to keep 3 or 4 on hand, but yeah. Mm. I'm not saying anything else. So the bottom now is home to more of the stuff that I don't use all of the time. So Steve cleared out the top shelf for me. Because I just couldn't do it. I can't see up there. I'm not getting on anything to climb up there neither. So crackers are going up there. Part bakes going up there. The large bags of snacks will go up there as well. Then the kids can't reach them. Although my 10-year-old is probably about 5'1" now. She's quite tall. She can reach more or less anywhere, so. Ooh, that soy sauce, that Emma's Basics at the front, is reduced salt. Really, really good. Just thought I'd mention that while you can see it. You can see it there, look. Well, you would if Steve kept the camera still. So there's his crackers and just the kids' stuff for packed lunches and breads. So yeah, that Emma's Basic. That is really, really good. I got it off Amazon. Especially if you're doing adobo or something that requires a lot of soy sauce. You don't want it salty. So that's the condiments. So much tidier and so much more room for me to put more in. And that's the one with all the pastas and such. And this is like packet mixes and oil. So it's a lot tidier, a lot better. And it needed doing. So part two will be coming. Thank you again to Naven for sponsoring this video. Yeah, I'll have the second part up, which is the spice cupboard and the spice rack, next week. So thanks so much for watching. Check out that doorbell, especially if you could use something like that. We've got it up. It's a fantastic little product. And don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, share it if you can, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.